Okay, so on today's episode of Crypto Scam Watch, we're looking at dodgy websites. And this one is something that is just constantly a threat in the crypto space. And you see examples of this on Reddit all the time. And I've got two quick examples here. And they were both essentially the same scammer. The same website changed the tool that it was hosting. And what we've got here is a scammy version of the Electrum website. And you can see it here. And if I switch from the scammy one to the legit one, you'll notice they look very, very similar on purpose. And there's only a few small differences. Specifically, the scammy one was talking about versions of Electrum that didn't quite exist yet. And you'll also notice that the scammy one removed the text about how learning how to verify GPG signatures. It's gone. But other than that, the scammy website had all the same colors, all the same artwork, all of that stuff to look very convincing to someone who wouldn't know better. And if we go to the download page on the scammy one, and this is a snapshot of what the Electrum website looked like at the time, we can see that the scammy one even was offering a slightly newer version of Electrum. How helpful! And they had all the downloads there with all the signatures. But again, like the previous page, they had simplified some of the language here. So they'd still included a legit signature that is actually the correct one you download off the website. But if you had downloaded them and actually verified them against the signature, you would discover that they contained a lot of malware. They were not authentic downloads at all. But other than that, the website was a very convincing lookalike. It was also from a different domain. And it was this domain here, so electrum.org hyphen secure app. And as you can see, if someone wasn't paying too much attention to what they were clicking on, they might think, oh yeah, that looks about right, and click on through. The same scammer was also hosting Ian Coleman's BIP39 tool. And if we compare this scammy website to the legitimate Ian Coleman one, we can see here the only real difference on the two pages was that the legit Ian Coleman one pointed to his official GitHub repository, and the scammy one pointed to their own server here and gave you a zip file that you had to download rather than bouncing you off to GitHub. Though, again, like a lot of these scams, they still include actual legit links to the proper GitHub repositories in and around their scammy bits. So these scam sites are made to look very, very, very much like the real deal, and they do catch a lot of people out. You see, the issue with this scammy version of the BIP39 tool is that it basically, as soon as someone entered in a mnemonic code in this field here, it sent a copy of that along with the passphrase to the scammer. So if someone made the mistake of running this tool on an internet-connected PC, it immediately sent their 24-word seed away to the scammer, whereas the official Ian Coleman tool doesn't do that. Both Trezor and Ledger are also often targeted with these scams, with people making websites that look very much like theirs that will say throw an error of some kind, like this one you can see here. It says, warning, Trezor data damage, do not disconnect your device, please enter your 24-word seed, or something along those lines. So what are some of the things you can look for with these scammy websites? Well, firstly, one of the things to look at with these is to see how recently the website was registered. Now, for this Electrum scam site, we could see when we looked up its domain registration, just on the official ICANN Whois lookup, we could see that that domain was only registered just in the last couple of months. Likewise, for this imitation BIP39 tool, it was only registered in the last couple of months. And this imitation Ledger domain was only registered just this month. So we can see that all three of these scammy websites, they're all very recent. Whereas when we look at the official websites of, say, Trezor and Ledger, we can see that they were both updated and recently created, sometime other than just last week or last month, with Trezor's one dating back to 2014, and with Ledger's one being an old domain, but still only being updated in 2018. And the other thing to look for is misspelled domain names or different domain suffixes. So you might have the correctly spelled ledger dot and then have some other different domain suffix, so say .net, .io, .org, anything else like that. And the same for Trezor. So how can you stay safe? Firstly, I'd suggest before anything else, use a modern browser. Like if you're still using Internet Explorer and you're dealing in crypto or if you're using an out-of-date version of the browser you're on, you really, really need to upgrade. I'm using Brave, the latest version of that, and I'm really enjoying that as a browser, and I've got a link to that in the description if you'd like to give it a go. Another really important way to stay safe is to make sure that you only run anything that uses your 24-word seed in an air-gapped amnesic environment. So that means a environment where you're not connected to the internet and you're not just using your normal desktop operating system, but rather something that wipes itself completely when you restart. And I'll put a link in the description to a video I've made about Tails Linux that can do that for you. At the very, very least, if you're running these sorts of tools that involve your 24-word seed on your desktop, you need to do that with your network disconnected. One of the key parts of this scam was that the scammer would encourage people to download this tool and run it standalone. What people didn't realize was that there was code in this scammy version of the web page that would send your information back to the scammer even if you were running it standalone. You also need to understand that just having a green padlock, so you know, a website that says it's secure, is actually not enough. All that means is that the traffic between you and the website you're talking to is encrypted. It doesn't actually verify that the person you're talking to, the website you're talking to, is the right website, let alone the official one. The other way to stay safe is to bookmark sites. Don't just Google them. The other thing you need to do is not just click on links that people send you in emails, private messages, or things like that, whether it's through Facebook, Reddit, or whatever. And this one's a really big one in that often, if you post on Reddit saying you're having trouble with your wallet, a whole bunch of scammers will immediately start sending you links to scammy websites, encouraging you to punch in your 24-word seed so they can help you and all those sorts of things. So, you know, don't just click on links people send you, regardless of who it's coming from, because, you know, for all you know, one of your friends may have had their social account compromised and it might just be spamming everyone on their contact list. The other thing you can do to stay safe, you can get browser plugins like Netcraft or Kryptonite online identity protection by Metacert that will actually help to check, I guess, a larger list of scammy websites and will help verify that the website you're on is in fact the right one. Though it's important to understand that these plugins, just like Google Safe Browsing, will only keep you safe after someone has reported the website has been malicious and that service has accepted it as a malicious website and start to block it. And for both of these websites I showed you, they both took about a week from when they first appeared on Reddit to when they were finally blocked consistently across a whole range of services. So while these tools can be really helpful, they are not going to be something that you can rely upon to keep you safe. So taking the time to learn how to verify download signatures is also a really important thing, and I'll cover that in a future video. So what you can do if you spot a scam? Well, firstly, you can report the website to Google Safe Browsing, and that's really handy in that it will block pretty much anyone using Chrome or Brave or a lot of other browsers. Likewise, you can report the website to Metacert, and all of these plugins in Chrome actually have options to report them in there. So usually just click on the extensions icon and you can then report a malicious URL for both Netcraft and Metacert. The other thing is that for a domain that you find that's scammy, you can also send an email to the abuse contact for there, and again, your mileage will vary depending on who is hosting the domain in terms of whether they'll actually do anything about it, let alone how long it might actually take them to do that. Thanks for watching. I hope that was helpful. Just hit subscribe if you'd like to be kept in the loop about future content I make to help people stay safe in the crypto space and to recover if they get into trouble. Or if there's a question you'd like some more information about or a topic you'd like me to cover in the future, just leave a reply.